Hello everybody, welcome back. Today we'll be continuing our preparation for the Salesforce Platform 1 Developer Certification Exam, and we'll be talking about the capabilities of the various relationship types and the implications of each on record access, user interface, and object-oriented program. Now this might sound a little complex, but they're just basically asking that you know how to set up relationships in Salesforce, the different types of relationships, and what their impact is regarding the data model. So users can create and define relationships between custom or standard objects. You can define a relationship between two custom objects, a custom and a standard object, or two standard objects. So there are two types of relationships. There's the lookup relationship and the master detail relationship. So different relationships may be appropriate depending on the use case. An example of a standard relationship would be how contact is related to account. The contact record contains a lookup and a reference to an account record. A lookup relationship creates a loosely coupled relationship between two objects. Because they're a loosely coupled relationship, record level access and ownership is treated independently. For example, a campaign can be owned by one user, but an opportunity that looks up to a campaign can be owned by another user. They can also have different levels of object permission as well. So they do not cause a cascade delete. So if you were to delete a campaign, it wouldn't delete the related opportunities and vice versa. When creating a lookup relationship, you can define the lookup filter and what to do if a lookup field is deleted. Let's look at some examples of how this would look. So in example one, we have two standard objects, a campaign and an opportunity. An opportunity can be related to a campaign, and opportunities appear as a related object under campaign. If you delete a campaign, it removes a reference on the opportunity, but does not actually delete the opportunity. Now let's look at a custom example. So let's say we have two objects, classroom and student. A classroom can have multiple students, and a student can be related to a classroom. Since a student may belong to other classrooms, you may want record ownership to be independent of the classroom. A master detail relationship creates a tightly coupled relationship between master and the child objects. Record level access and ownership is controlled by the parent. Deleting the parent causes the cascade deletion of a child. A master relationship allows roll-up summary on the master or parent object. So let's say you had a order object and you wanted to summarize the order detail being the children. The order details can be summarized on the master order object. Let's look at an example of master detail, an account and opportunity. Since an opportunity indicates an account's interest in a product or service, it makes sense an account would be required. And if you delete an account, it also makes sense to remove all child opportunities. Ownership of the account also can drive ownership of the opportunity. In some cases, you'll want to create a junction object. A junction relationship consists of two parents and one child. If one of the parents are deleted, the junction record is also deleted. An example would be a job application object that's related as a junction object to a position object and a candidate object. This is needed so a candidate can apply to multiple positions, because you do not want to remove a candidate just because a position is deleted. Now for a scenario-based question. An organization wants to keep a relationship between employees and managers. An employee should be able to change managers, and an employee might not have a manager for a period of time. What relationship would accommodate this? If you think you know the answer, leave it in the comment section.